Good evening, everyone. Oops, hide the camera. I hide it. Okay. So, they are a little bit early, but we are having a very interesting game at our hand. So quickly go into the matchup. I didn't even get a chance to see that we are starting streaming. So, we have Catalonia versus France. At least the title is correct. A very interesting matchup. So for Catalonia, we have Baratian trading Quick Cover. We've seen it a lot through the normal Swiss rounds. But for France, we have Baratian move with restricted card Warp, which I found very interesting. For Catalonia, restricted card is Queen Celeste. And I'll quickly go over the deck. So Barakuhor is written in Counting Coppers. We haven't seen that plot in ages. We have Late Summer Feast, One from the Iron Bank, Political Disaster, Rationing, Winter Festival, and You Win or You Die. So a standard Rushy Rush deck. Events, two copies of Hand Judgment. And then we have for the attachment side, we have 3 times Azor Ahai, 3 times Red God Blessing, and interesting enough, there is nothing to cycle the Azor Ahai with in the deck. So there are 2 copies of Bodyguard, and then Warhammer, Strangler, Seized by the Guard, Whitebringer, Hunting Axe, and Dispute Flame. Yep, there is no seal here to cycle the Azor Ahai, but looks like it just depends on being a boss and drawing it. Again, from characters, it's running the standard Stannis, Robert, Celeste. Mel, and that's pretty much it. I don't see Imri Florent. I would have loved to see it, but the deck is running a very light economy package, which is Dragonstone Port, King's Road, Roadroads. For the Barrow Wolf deck, there is a lot of stuff going on here. We have a Chamber Ikea set, running a Frozen Solitaire to the Crown Warp as an attachment. And only events is seen in flames with 3 copies of it. So this looks like a ladies list to some extent, or and built to be an early aggressor. We have 2 copies of Queen Celeste, 6 costs, the one that kneels all non-lady characters, and everything is a lady here, or most of it. So plot wise, we see Peace and Prosperity. I was about to say that it's in the plot deck. So plot wise, we have Feast for Crows at the Palace of Sorrows, Building Orders, Calling the Banners, Counting Coppers, again, Peace and Prosperity, and Valar Dohaeris. I would have expected to see March, considering there is a ward in the deck, but or the sacrifice event, but that's not the case. From the star cards, we already mentioned Frozen Solent and Ward, then 2 copies of Corset Aria, 2 copies of Bran, Corset Bran, 3 copies of Greyjoy Number, copy of Jean Pool, and 2 copies of Last Heart Scout and Corset Sansa. So a little bit of passive power there, but we'll see how this will play out. So the night is full of Catalonia France matchups, so I'll try to cover as many as I can. Although commentary may be a little bit lacking due to a random headache that I have all day, but oops, no, get it. Okay, so you saw the World Cup banner guy. Hey, welcome, Alejandro. Yep, hype. So let's see what the Root Priest will remove. We didn't talk about setup a lot. Great setup for both factions. We are done with the setups. Interesting enough, no attachments anywhere to be seen, but we have Root Priest. Also, no Roro character, which is first player. Okay, so Gabriel already played. So as I said, on the bottom we have France, and on the top we have Catalonia. I should make a small flux and add them somewhere, like here maybe. What do you think, Alejandro? Over the plots, for the countries? At least now there are very few countries, so. No, who's who? Looks like the hand is pretty stuck considering the command. And to considering there is a one gold, I assume there is sin in flames in hand. So male will probably be knelt. We'll see. I have to find a good array of flags, but luckily there are not that many countries that are currently in the list. And Red Priest removes a ward. Looks like a solid choice to me. Yep, that is true. We know most of the names by now, but and we have male kneeling Angui and Alistair for Carlo. So pretty stacked hand. Also considering that Alistair hit the board, that makes a perfect sense why the ward was played, and we have here a God Blessing. Why the ward was removed. And then we have here God Blessing. So I assume there is a. Another Red God Blessing. So I assume we're going to see seen in flames here. And kneeling probably Alistair. Although there is no military icon on this side, so probably so Angui will probably bite the dust. Yeah, it's a singleton, so I don't expect him to survive the challenges phase. No challenges for Gabriel. And as predicted, there is the military challenge. Chut. So looks like here the plan for Gabriel is to limit, aside from drawing a little bit of cards, to limit the Brown. That's an interesting choice. I would stop Brown, but considering there is only two copies of Hand Judgment in your opponent deck, maybe makes sense. Although you're running copy of this and not copy of this, so Angry. Well, that doesn't make that much sense to me. I wonder if you're going to see Seen in Flames played now. A kneeling, probably male. No. Oh. So he's fighting for the dominance. Here. Also interesting enough, we don't see triggering of the Kofor agenda. Pick up Bannerman discarded random. That's not a card seen outside of a Hano deck that he made popular recently. And we see one of the records blessing changed for a sending accident on Sansa, so no power gained from there. And dominance goes to Gabriel, so this will allow his Norton encampment to stand. No War Infiltrator triggers. So next spots. I think it's a little bit early for the Harry, so maybe calling the banners. Or he's going directly into building orders, and then we have rationing. Okay. So who do you guys think is favorite in this matchup, the Kuhor or the Wolf? I'm currently not sure, honest, to be completely honest. The King's Road and Root Priest hitting the board. Let's see what the hit will be here. So, if Robert or Stannis are there, it should be either of them. Yep. Seized by the guard. Okay. So his goal is to protect his combo situation. That makes sense. Yeah, I would have expected to see a march considering we have the ward, or maybe a little bit of the kill guys. Bottom flares if he wanted to go attrition, but looks like that's not the full scale of the plan. But we will see. Looks like there is a big guy there. Oh, we haven't seen her in ages. So another war character, a little bit weirdly costed. Also has an art from another card from first edition that was lovely. I call it had vigilant and stealth. Something along those lines. Name an event type until the end of the phase. Events with that title cannot be played. So I assume here we're going to see Seen in Flames. Mentioned male knelt. Why male and not the Angui that's going to do challenges? Like efficient challenges. And Moon Boy. And Azorahai, where did it went? Scent of Mail, okay. Unfortunately, priority is on the Barrow side, so maybe the Senior Flames will fire off now, although there won't be any milling. This Mail has triggered already. Another point here is that the Barakuhor is going pretty wide currently. Okay, there's the Dragon of Sinian Flames mentioned. Again, the effective military challenge. So I think that the Barakuhor should wait for the Duhaeris until at least one of the big guys hits the board. But we'll see. I would have been tempted to and now he has power on his station. I would have been tempted to play it earlier just because if the Red Priest is not kept, that makes the situation very weird what's kept and whatever is kept could be stolen with ward. So that would have been an option to be able to go a little bit aggressive, but looking at the how the game is played out currently, there isn't any lack of characters to say on the Barakuhor side. Not much action happening, so he stones storm drum discarded at random. I wonder if you're going to see a trigger here. So another red god blessing is discarded for disputed claim. So this will give renown to Mel. And she will be in all the chains. So we are seeing the rush option now. Triggering looks like the Voltron is going to be Mel this time around. We see a post military challenge, claim will be probably Sansa. No point in being the Red Priest at this stage, also removing one more target for Kuhor. I believe there is one more disputed claim in the deck. Quickly check. No, it's only one copy of it, so this is the only source of renown for Mel. And we need a power challenge. Inside from Moonboy. I wonder if we're gonna see, but there is no attachment left to be sacrificed, so. Chamber trigger. At least the chamber will keep the power equal so Mel doesn't get out of hand. For the disputed claim, you need to have more power on your faction hand than your opponent. Now,
Unfortunately, I do think it's time for a Duharis. Looking at this situation, the ward will be most of the cases free, so you'll be able to take advantage of it. But that will, and the Seized by the Guard will stay there. I assume both players are running Crescent. There is one copy in the Barrow Wolf. And no copies. Oh, brave. In the Cohort, considering how many builders there are. Although Cohort doesn't probably care because of the high. Yeah, a little bit brave to not be running. Anything of that sort. We have calling the banners into you win or you die. So it appears to me that the Barrow thinks there is more time, but I don't feel like that for some reason. But next turn will be an amazing Duharis, considering that the Martin player will be without cards, but he's going to play Counting Coppers then. So, Dupe for Mel. Will we see another Red Priest? Would love to see now a Queen Mel, Queen Celis. Would be amazing. Unfortunately, he is first player, but all of the chaff will be nailed, including Mel. So this is a turn bot, but we'll see if this will be the case. And there are quite a lot of big array of cards in the Baratheon hand. But unfortunately, the two copies of Red God Blessing that give the reward trait are gone now, so. So he has to depend on a character. Do what he wanna do, and there will be probably a single challenge, unless he marshals like crazy several characters. We see a King's Road. And great job! Hey! Is he still alive? He is still active. So we'll see an intimidate from him. Brownstone Faithful. Looks like I'll have to zoom out. Sorry about that, but we'll be. Unfortunately, the active cards will be on the right. And we see Greyjoy nailed from thanks to the Dramaton Convert. And we have a bodyguard. I wonder why on Mel. Doesn't she have a dupe? She does have a dupe and another one. For Alistar. So he didn't find any of the big guys. Surprisingly, they're hiding at the bottom of the deck. We are going to see. Now the question is, how does the Barrow Wolf proceed with his challenges here? Yep, we see again triggering convert for seeing flames. The question is which challenge will convert will decide to win and which will he will not. No surprise we don't see any challenges from Gabriel. Oh, Big Yon. So which challenge would you sacrifice here if you're the Barak 4 player? So Mel will not get renowned this turn from the looks of it. So it doesn't matter in what order you do the challenges. I think the power claim is more important. So just do the power challenge and get your claim. Oh no, with claim you have renown, so definitely the power first. Yep, definitely just do the power. I don't think there is another way around it. Interesting. Yeah, power. I will do power here. The others don't make any sense. And looks like he reached to the same conclusion. Our challenge is a 2 power swing. We see on a full challenge and Mel is going to stand for dominance with the throne. So we see bodyguard changed for the milk of the poppy. Oh, Mel, okay. Chamber. And we are 8-3. So let's see what was in the hand. Two copies of hand judgment, Imri and Zorahai. Not bad. So yep, as mentioned, to carry this into counting. So let's see what will stay on the board and what won't. So we see the Kukor player being first, which could backfire, I feel like. And I'm curious what he's going to save here. I definitely wouldn't have let him go first, considering that I'm probably Melisandre, Red Priest, Dragonstone Faithful, Dragonstone Faithful. So he decided not to keep the to keep the priest and leave with all the other big hitters, which is a very interesting choice. And we see here Mail, Angui and Red Priest. So this will allow recycling of Celeste, which is good. And we know there are more copies of Greyjoy in the deck, so Drotty, though two more, and he is back in business. And we see Whitebringer on Mel, so there will be a little bit of stand there. Nirik, Angui and Mel was nailed thanks to Alistar. We see Acolyte of the Flame, one of my recently found favorite cards. Is the Northern Compound triggering? It looks like that will be the full marshalling. Surprisingly, we still haven't seen any of the big guys there, but that's for the better, for the good, considering the situation Bara Wolf is. Is there a reset? There is no reset in the core deck. A lot more people joining. Oof. So he definitely needs a ward at this situation to take that red priest and to reduce the challenges and that can be thrown at him in his direction. Yep. And traitor, so no power challenge basically. I would have taken the priest definitely. But now there is definitely really no power challenge, so maybe that was a better choice. But Mel will still get the intrigue and military claim. I'm gonna see intrigue with Mel. It should be a post. Unfortunately, at this stage in the game. Because you're probably giving the Aquite of the Flame for claim. Looks like not. Then how are you opposing now the Inter challenge? The military that is coming going to come from the we see bodyguard change for a warhammer male standing renown military, going to go on a post and probably a dupe of mail will go away. And now the power challenge will go through thanks to the Dragonstone Faithful. Oh, we see Whitebringer sacrificed. Ah, so this is going to bring the last Red Ghost Blessing and it's going to go on the Dragonstone at one of the Dragonstone Fetals, which will give the power icon for the last challenge. There are no more Red Ghost Blessings in the deck. And if we have a power challenge, or wait, why would I don't understand why was not the power challenge with this guy? What did I miss, guys? I'm really confused here. So he's the one thing to win the dominance this way, but this would have given him renown, so one more power he would have been at 13. So is the dominance that more important here? I mean, he would have still now this way he also reaches 13, so yeah, makes sense actually. Yep. Now it's 11-9. The dominance. So looks like next turn will be the last one. And quick look at plots. So for Kuhor, I assume that we're gonna see Winter Festival. Just to secure the it wasn't played, yeah. So I'm definitely sure that next plot will be Winter Festival for the core player. And for the Wolf, probably the Palace of Sorrows. Although that's highly unlikely. But there isn't anything else that could help him in this situation. Unfortunately, he is not playing the Nearing event, which I find very weird. A snap pick for Catalonia, and I'm pretty sure it's going to be the Winter Festival. Oh, Mail doesn't contribute its power to the dominance race. I forgot about that. Then he should have made the challenge with the Dragonstone Faithful with this one. Maybe he forgot as well, like me. Yep. We see the past of Sorrows with Winter Festival. I would be tempted to trigger the Aquite of the Flames here. Interesting enough, why did he decide to let the player that can close first again? And definitely we see him use the Aquite of the Flames. He decided not to put them at the bottom, so they are definitely not great. You see Queen Celeste. Unfortunately, all the attachments are now gone. New one, male. Why not on? And GG. So is it would be yeah. Yep. So. Yep, for the next game definitely gonna zoom in back. But the board was like open to here and I went. So yeah. Now quickly going to find the next game and see what's going on there. This is Poland Terrell versus Netherlands Greyjoy. No, there should have been Catalonia game. And there is another Poland. All the games are tonight, so which one do we